Hey guys, welcome to another video from Flash Engineer. This time we'll check out the working of a bug boost converter with waveforms, its advantages, disadvantages, and an application. So let's go for a ride. The bug boost converter is made of MOSFET, a diode, an inductor, and an output capacitor. The PWM pulses are given to the gate of the MOSFET, which switches the MOSFET on and off, and that's how the output voltage is adjusted. The output voltage which we get out of it is of reverse polarity. That means if the positive voltage is given at the input, then the output voltage will be of negative value. The bug boost converter is a very basic DC to DC converter, where its output can either be greater or less than the input voltage. It is a step up and step down converter. The construction of the bug boost converter is just like the flyback converter, but instead of using a transformer, it only has an inductor. The formula of the output voltage is given like this. Here, the negative sign shows that the polarity of the output voltage is reversed. So, now let's see the working of the bug boost converter. It will be easy to understand in terms of the reluctance of an inductor to allow the rapid change in the current. Initially, when the supply is given, but the MOSFET is turned off, there is no current flowing through this circuit. But when the MOSFET is turned on, the current flows through the MOSFET and inductor only. This diode prevents the current from flowing into the output of the circuit because it is reverse biased, so it actually blocks the current supply. However, since the inductor doesn't allow rapid current change, it will initially keep the current low by dropping most of the voltage on it. Basically, initially, it acts as the high resistance component. But after some time, the inductor will allow the current to flow and decrease the voltage drop across it. So, after some time, the resistance of the inductor decreases. During this time, the inductor will store the energy inside of it. But there is no current flowing through the output load. Now the MOSFET is turned off. Due to sudden drop in the current, the inductor induces the flyback voltage, which has a magnitude of V is equal to LdI by dt, where L is the inductance and di by dt is the change in current over time. During this time, the polarity of the inductor reverses and current starts flowing through this direction. So due to that, the diode is forward biased and this inductor provides the voltage to the output load, but this is an inverting direction. The capacitor connected here filters out the ripple present in the supply. Well, let's understand the working of this converter with waveforms. Initially, the PWM is given to the gate of the MOSFET. Let's consider this is an n-channel MOSFET. When the gate pulse is high, the MOSFET turns on. So now, the MOSFET is on. So the current starts flowing through the MOSFET and increases linearly with respect to time due to this inductor. So, the current across the inductor also starts increasing. Now, if you see the circuit diagram, the inductor is connected directly to the supply. So the voltage across inductor is equal to supply voltage. The diode D1 in this case is reverse biased, so there is no current flowing through this. So this circuitry is totally isolated from the supply, there is no current flowing through the capacitor and there is no voltage across load as well. Now in the second cycle, the MOSFET is turned off. The current flowing through the MOSFET falls to zero immediately. Now, the inductor starts providing energy which it had stored in the earlier cycle. so the inductor current starts decreasing. During this time, the polarity of the inductor reverses, so the voltage of the inductor goes to a negative value and reaches to that particular voltage which it has to provide to the output. So this voltage is the required voltage. The designer has to calculate all the parameters and control loop to get this required output voltage. If you want me to provide those design parameters of the buck boost converter, please let me know in the comment section. I'll add this topic in my video list. Now coming back to the waveforms. Here the inductor is working as a source and its polarity has reversed. The diode is forward biased, so the value of the current flowing through the diode will be the same as that of the inductor current. Now the output voltage is constant DC, which is provided by the inductor, but it is of negative value. Now again, the MOSFET is turned on. This time, all the parameters such as MOSFET current, inductor voltage, and diode current behaves the same as it was in the first cycle. But this time, the output voltage and current is still constant, and this power is provided by the output capacitor, which has stored the charge in the first place. When the inductor was supplying the power to the load, this guy was storing the charge that time. So when the inductor gets charged to the supply, that time the capacitor provides the power to the load. So the load doesn't get affected in either of these cycles. So when the MOSFET is off, inductor provides power to the load. And when the MOSFET is turned on, the capacitor provides power to the load. And that's how a buck boost converter works. The converter like this is very suitable for applications like maximum power point tracking for a solar panel. The voltage generated from solar power is never constant, because it changes according to the intensity of sunlight. If we take an example, the voltage of a solar panel can range from 10 volts to 18 volts. And from this solar panel, we need to charge a battery which has a nominal voltage of 12 volts. So to charge this battery, we need to step down the 18 volts to 12 volts and step up the 10 volts to 12 volts. So for this application, the buck boost converter is an ideal choice. Due to limited number of components, the cost and complexity of the converter is minimized. Well, there are some drawbacks of this converter. The active switch, that is MOSFET, is a floating switch. It does not have any ground terminal. In order to turn on the MOSFET, some gate threshold voltage has to be given at the gate to source. For example, if an N-channel MOSFET has a minimum gate threshold voltage of 4 volts to turn it on, then minimum 4 volts has to be given between its gate and source. This becomes very easy when the source of the MOSFET is connected to ground. But if the MOSFET is at the high side, as shown in the buck boost topology, then just providing the 4 volts to the gate with respect to ground will not turn on the MOSFET. For that, we need a special circuitry which is known as high side gate drivers. So driving the MOSFET in this configuration becomes a little tricky. Nowadays, nobody uses this topology in the actual system due to its numerous disadvantages. But this is the base of all step up and step down converters. So I hope you understood something from this. If you have any question, let me know in the comment section. Hit the like button if you like this video, subscribe to my channel, and finally, thanks for watching.